Nota niño ye a soya.
Bonjour tout le monde. Donc aujourd'hui, je vous propose mon troisième petit entretien que j'ai fait avec Ni, mon ami qui habite au Myanmar. Dans les deux premiers entretiens, c'était vraiment comme de l'exploration. Le but, c'était vraiment comme de partager ce que lui vivait. Dans ce troisième entretien, on passe à l'action. Dans un premier temps, je vous propose d'écouter l'entretien, puis on se reparle à la toute fin.
It seems to be sunny this morning.
Yeah, it's too hot.
Yeah.
Outside and inside.
Ah, that's good.
Ni, tell me, how's the situation right now in Myanmar?
The situation is not like the same situation the first interview and the second interview time. Until now, you know, over 800 people have already died, have already killed by the military junta, including 52 children. Over 5,000 young generation protesters have already detained. I have no words to say.
And what about the situation in the day-to-day life? Like, how is it in the street? Is it still very dangerous?
In Yangon, lots of places boom everywhere. Boom. They make an explosion and to give the fears to the people. Boom is everywhere, you know, everywhere.
You talked to me about something that happened in a market in the middle of the country. Can you tell me exactly what happened?
The market, you know, they do not want to sell their goods to the police and the soldiers. Over 900 shops have already damaged by fire. Over 1,000 soldiers, after they control, they use a machine gun. They use a sniper. They shoot whoever they see on the road. So they destroyed the buildings and they took all goods, money from the civilians' people. If the military do not stop this situation, the civil wars can happen.
With this third interview, Ni, I want to invite the people who will listen to the video to donate for helping the people of Myanmar. So can you tell me what is your plan? What are you going to do with the money you will receive?
Yeah. In Minda is the small hilly region. Now they will be refugees. All the people, they are not to stay in the township. They are going to the forest, over 3,000 people. In the rainy season time, they will need a medicine or some of the food, tanks. My second target is the CDM people, civil disobedience.
Yeah.
Teacher, some of the government employees who don't want to join with the military junta, I will support them. So my main target is 2 persons.
Yeah.
It will be helpful for the people, including me.
I mean, you're so inspiring. You're so strong. Even though everything that is happening, you keep your smile. It's really something for me to talk to you. It's a chance. And how do you say thank you in Myanmar? I forgot.
Jesube.
And
when we get our better life, please come and visit to me.
Ah, for sure.
I will invite you.
For sure, I will be back. I will be back.
So we will fight what we can.
Yeah.
And to get what we want. Thanks deeply for all the people and from me. Thank you deeply. Huh?
Donc, je pense qu'on peut vraiment faire une différence concrète, vous et moi. Et pour ce faire, j'ai créé un GoFundMe. Mon but, c'est de collecter 5 000 $. Je pense que c'est un montant qui est réaliste. Pour vous donner une idée, si on est 250 personnes à contribuer à une hauteur de 20 $ chacun, on récolte 5 000 $. Je pense que vous avez vu, les images parlent d'elles-mêmes. Le témoignage de Ni parle de lui-même. Merci beaucoup d'avoir écouté la vidéo. Merci pour votre participation. Puis, n'hésitez pas surtout à partager la vidéo pour rejoindre le plus de gens possible pour qu'on puisse atteindre le plus gros montant possible. Merci beaucoup. Au plaisir de vous voir, tout le monde. Salut.